Today, in last class, we have started the design of the compression member. Once the load is given, how to get the element? Okay, for the given load, how to design for the element? So next problem, we have done there single angle and double angles on both side of the gusset plate and angle either side of the gusset plate. And now today we are going to do with the different elements. So we'll take up a problem. Okay, this is second one. A column consists of four equal angle arranged in a form of a square section. So he wants four angles to form a square section of side. He has given the side of 400 mm. Design the section. Design the section if the column carries, if the column carry a load of 800 kilonewton, the length of the column is 5 meters. He has given the length. Both the ends of the column are restrained in position but not in direction. The end condition is given, restrained in the position but not in the direction. So what do you mean by that? It is a hinged. See, both the ends are hinged. Here L equal to 5 meters. That's what it is given. Now, he has given four angles which forms a square shape. Okay, I'll put the four angles. So this four corners, I'll put the four angles. He has given, it forms a square section of side 400. That's what I'm writing here. Each side forms a 400 mm. Each corner an angle is kept. Okay. Now, the given thing is, given What are the given? Load is given, axial load. Axial load equal to 800 kilonewton. And the length of the member is given, I have put already. And they are of 4 angles of 400 mm side. This is the given thing. Now, allowable compressive stress. Allowable compressive stress. For angles, generally we'll take from 0.4 Fy to 0.6 Fy. Okay. So here I'll take 0.4 Fy. Okay. So 0.4 of 250, it is 100 Newton per mm square. That's what I have taken. Now, area required, isn't it? You know the load, you know the stress, then you can easily calculate the area. So, area required, it equals to load divided by stress, because stress is load divided by area. So area required is load divided by stress, that is 800 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 100. It comes to 8000 mm square. 8000 mm square. So you have to search an angle. All four angles together, it comes to 8000 mm square. So each, therefore, each area of an angle equal to, or one area of angle is 8000 divided by 4, you will get 2000 mm square. So this is the required area. We have to search for a element, angle which have the 2000 mm square area. Okay. Now, increase the area by 25%. We do whenever angles are there. This is the standard procedure. Taking 0.4 to 0.6 Fy is one criteria. Then second criteria, increase by 25%. Therefore, required area of angle equal to 2000 into 1.25. Increase by 25%. So you'll get 2500 mm square. So you have to search an angle which have 2500 mm square. I will try angle ISA 130 into 130 into 12. Okay, you open the steel table of page number 12 of SP6. Okay, if you open it, you will get this ISA. Details of ISA are there, 130 into 12. So here, what are the details? I'll take area. Area equal to 29.82 centimeter square. You convert into millimeter, that is multiply with 100, that becomes area in mm square. Then, and IXX equal to IYY, because this is a equal angle, you will get IXX equal to IYY, that equal to 473.8 centimeter to the power of 4. The values will be available in the steel table in centimeters. So we have four angles. So for the given four angles, what will be the IXX? IXX equal to IYY equal to 4 of 473.8 area. IXX, this is applying parallel axis theorem. IXX plus AH square area is 29.82 into d by 2. This 20 is nothing but d by 2. Okay, minus of CYY, we had to put 3.66 square. This is CYY of IS 8 113 to 113 to 12. So I'll get A plus, that is IXX plus AH square of four angles. I'll get in centimeters 33742 centimeter to the power of 4. In millimeters, 33742 into 10 raised to 4 mm to the power 4. Once I get this, I'll calculate the R minimum. So R minimum equal to square root of I by A. So square root of 33742 into 10 raised to 4 divided by area. What's the area provided is 29.82 into 100. We get this value as 168.2 mm. Once you get R in minimum, next thing, finding slenderness ratio. Slenderness ratio lambda equal to Le by R minimum. So Le is equal to L. That is 5000 divided by 168.2. You will get 29.7 as the lambda. Now, once you get the lambda, what is our next step? As usual procedure, finding the safe load of the given section, that should be greater than the load provided. That's the procedure. Okay. Now, this being a built-up section, so built-up section, the buckling class is C from table 10, isn't it? So we got the class C. Refer table 9C to find allowable compressive stress, FCD. So if you refer the table for lambda and FCD, I want for 29.7, for 20 the value is 224, then for 30 it is 211, I want 29.7. For the 29.7, it is 211.39 Newton per mm square. Once you get this, therefore, the compressive strength P equal to AG into FCD. Our AG is 2982 into 211.39 FCD value. I'll divide by 1000 so that directly I'll get in the kilonewton. 2521 kilonewton, which is greater than 800 kilonewton. So here what happens? See, 800 is less than 1000, isn't it? We got 2500. It is not in that economical. So what we will do, we will go for little lesser area of the element so that we will get economical section. So we will try four angles of ISA 60 into 60 into 10 mm. Okay, go to that page on steel tables, get the area and IXX of the particular element. Area is 11 centimeter square, IXX is 34.8 centimeter to the power 4. Now, IXX of given section, or selected section, okay, 4 times 34.8, that is IXX plus AH square 20 minus 1.85 square. This is CYY of the ISA 60 into 60 into 10. So here I'll get 1433.79 centimeter square. Now if we take RXX and RYY of the value, in that minimum R minimum, you will get it as 182.4 mm from the SP6. Okay, these values are also from SP6. Okay, so once I get R minimum, usual procedure, you proceed as we have done in the last case. So slenderness ratio lambda equal to LE by R minimum. So here LE equal to 5000 divided by yes, 5000 divided by 182.4. If I do, I will get it as 274.1. Okay, this is the lambda value. Then calculate the FCD. Okay, if you calculate the FCD value using table 9C, because it is a buckling class C, isn't it? So FCD will become 216.38 Newton per mm. You know how to calculate using the 9C. Okay, say if load or permissible load or design load, say if load equal to AG into FCD, that equal to 1100 into 216.38. I'll get 943.9 kilonewton, which is greater than 800 mm. So this is almost near to the required, sorry, kilonewtons, this is required load. Therefore, adopt four angles of ISA 60 into 60 into 10 mm. This the way we do. If the angles are given, spacings are given, and load is given, so this is the method we have to do. Okay, what are the things you had to find out? You had to find out the I of the section IXX and IYY. This being a square, IXX equal to IYY. Get the I minimum, then get R minimum, then get lambda. Once you get lambda, refer to the built-up section class 9C. Then get the FCD value. FCD value multiplied with the area, you will get the safe load which can carry by the element. That should be greater than the allow the load which passes through it. Then the section will be safe. Okay. Now we will do the next problem. Here, we'll take a I section here. Okay. Take down the problem. Design a column section. Design a column section using single rolled steel beam. Single rolled steel beam along with cover plates. Here we are providing cover plates to the I section to get the more value of moment of inertia. Okay, so lesser value of the radius of gyration, so that we get the lesser value of the slenderness ratio. So cover plates, the length of the column, the length of the column is 6 meters. Okay. The factor load of 2000 kilonewton acts on the column. Okay. The column is rigidly fixed on both the ends. So he has given the end condition, the both the ends are fixed. Okay, this is the condition given. Okay, so here giving end condition, so what will be the L effective? Referring to the table, it is 0.65 L, that is 0.65 of 6000. You will get it as 3900 mm is the length of the member. Then what more things he has given? Single I section along with carries the cover plates. This is the I section. The flanges are carrying the covering plates. He want this type of the, demanding this type of the section to carry this load. So we have to search in steel tables where I with the cover plates. We'll come to that. Okay. Now first we'll calculate the area required. Isn't it? That's our prime first step. Okay, so here assuming allowable compressive stress or allowable FCD, Here I will take, if it is a I and T section, allowable, assuming allowable, I'll rewrite this, allowable compressive stress FCD equal to 0.8 times the Fy. So 0.8 into 250, that is 200 Newton per mm square. Okay. Now, once we get this area required, next step is area required. The same steps, but here how to select is the little different from the last problem, because here we are using I section with the covering plates. Okay, so load divided by FCD, the load is here, the load 2000 divided by into 10 raised to 3, I'll convert into kilonewton divided by 200, you'll get 10,000 mm square is the required area. Now you have to take the SP6 steel tables. You go for page number 169, and page number 169, it is given section part D of the steel tables are, so the elements used for the columns, it is given. What are the used as columns, the sections used as columns. Okay, once you open from there, they have given the different sections which can be used for the columns. Now go to the page number 174. Page number 174, we'll try ISHB 150 at 34.6 kg per meter. You go to the particular column, ISHB 150, 34.6 is the weight, page number 174. Okay, there the cover plate, they have given cover plate width as 250 mm and different thicknesses of the cover plate. So I will selecting 250 into 12 mm. I am selecting the plate thicknesses taller. There are different plate thicknesses. You can select any one which you want, so that the required area, it should satisfy the area required. So the area of ISHB, what I have selected, 150 at 34.6 is equal to 104.08 centimeter square. I'll multiply with the 100 so that I can write mm square. So this is 10,000 what required. I have taken little higher. I'll try. If I get unsafe, I'll revise the section. Then what more thing you have to take, Rx in x direction, that is nothing but our z direction, is equal to 7.32 centimeters, and Ry value from the steel table, it is 5.9 centimeter. From these two, what is the minimum R? Is 59 millimeter. I'll put in millimeter. The radius of gyration R minimum I have taken, and the given is end conditions. I know R minimum. I know. Then I'll calculate slenderness ratio. The same procedure. I told you same procedure. Only thing is how to select here from page number 174 where I section with the cover plates are given. The total properties of that are given. Area, R axis, I axis, all the values in the steel table. That you have to select. Then this procedure, remaining procedure is same. Slenderness ratio lambda is equals to LE by R minimum. So LE is 3900, the effective length divided by 59. I will get 66.1. Then this being a built up section, referring to the table 4, referring to table 10, this comes to buckling class C. So refer to table 9C to get FCD value. Referring table 9C, what you will get? You have lambda values, you have FCD values. It is 66, means I have to get the values between 60 and 70. So for 60, it is the value 168. For 70, 152. I am interested in 66.1. If I interpolate it, I'll get the value. I got the value as 158.24 newton per mm square. Okay. Once you get the FCD value, find the safe load. Okay. So compressive strength equal to strength P equal to Ag into FCD. Our area is 10408 into 158.24. I got 1647 kilonewtons, which is less than 2000. Why I have taken this example means area required, if you take area exactly, I have taken 10,408, isn't it? For 10,000 required, you will get the unsafe. So once you get an unsafe, what you have to do? We have to revise. We call revise the section. That is the word use. Revise section. Revise section means again you take the little bigger area of the section, then try for the check whether it is correct or not. Now I'll consider ISHB 150 at 30.6 kg per meter. Here the area is a little more. Okay. So you have to search like that. With the covering plate, what? With cover plate. With cover plate 250 into 25 mm I'll take here. So that I'll get little area more. The area is 163.98 centimeter square. That I'll write in millimeter, 163.98 into 100 millimeter square. Then again, I have to see the Rx value in the book. Rx equal to Rz, that is 8.26 centimeters in this details you get in SP6. Okay, ry value is 6.52. So which is r minimum? R minimum is nothing but 65.2 mm. So this is the value I have to consider. Then usual procedure. What's the usual procedure? Calculation of slenderness ratio. Slenderness ratio lambda equal to le by r minimum. So 3900 divided by 65.2, I'll get 59.81. So this comes to the buckling class C. We know that. So this is buckling class C. Refer table 9C for the FCD value. If you refer that, for lambda 50, the FCD value is 183. For lambda 60, it is 168. I am interested in 59.81, which gives me the value 168.285 Nm². Once you get the FCD value, once you get the FCD value, calculate the load. Now, the compressive strength equal to AG into FCD. Okay, 163.98 into 100 is my area. Then 168.285 is the FCD, what I got it. This is 3000.85 kilonewtons, which is greater than 2000 kilonewton, hence safe. So here what we learnt in this problem is how a I section, if it is I section with the plates, is given the remedy allowable. The properties of the I section are given in the code book. Just take those values and design. And one more thing we learned, the area selection should be little higher. Exactly, if you take, you may get unsafe. Not an every time, but here we got an unsafe. So to get a safer values, we have to take little more higher area. Okay, now, yeah, we'll go for the channel sections. If channel sections are given, generally we take I sections with the plate, simply I section, okay, angle sections, then channel section. So we'll do problem on the channel sections. Take the problem. Design a compression member. Design a compression member using double channel means two channels, double channel section which are tau to tau. This is also called phase to phase. Tau to tau are phase to phase, both are same. Okay, placed which are tau to tau, a factored load of 1600 kilonewtons is acting on the column. the column end, the column end conditions are, the column end conditions are 1 end is fixed, 1 end is fixed and other end is hinged. This is the end condition given. Okay. And now we'll consider FE 410 where FI value is 250, the yield strength. Okay. Now assuming compressive strength equal to 0.8 of FY, we will get 2000 Newton per mm square. The same procedure. Now area required equal to load divided by stress, that is load is 1600 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 200, sorry this is 200 not 2000, 200, okay, I'll strike it, 200, if I divide, how much I'll get? 8000 mm square, that is nothing but 80 centimeter square area. I have to search two angles together, I should get 80 centimeter square. So area of one channel section equal to 80 by 2, it is 40 centimeter square. We have to search a section in the steel table which gives you 40 centimeter square. Okay. Now, from SP6 or steel tables, we will try 2 ISLC, Indian Standard Lightweight Channel 300 at, for the column we have selected this, okay, 33.1 kg per meter. I have taken two sections of ISLC 300 where 300 represents the depth. Now it is given in page number 6 of SP6, the properties. What are the properties of section are given? What are the required area? Area is 4211 mm. I am writing in mm square, that will be given in centimeter square. IXX value I want 6047.9 centimeter square. I'll put in millimeter, multiply with 10 raised to 4 mm to the power 4. Then I want IYY equal to 346 centimeter square, centimeter to the power of 4. I want in millimeter, I'll multiply 10 raised to 4 to get in millimeter. Then I want CYY value 25.5 mm. Then width of the channel, that is 100. These details I require. Now, how it is placed? I said it is toe to toe. Okay. So this is the toe to toe facing. Back to back means the channels are placed like this. Okay. So the first one is called toe-to-toe or face-to-face. The second one we call back-to-back. So I'll put a figure, okay, of the channel section which are faced toe to toe. This is one channel section. Okay, the other channel section. This is the arrangement, toe to toe. Now this is YY, this is ZZ axis. Okay. Now this is the width B. Now CYY, say this is Y axis, this from the base, this is CYY. That's what we have taken. That is actually 2.5 centimeters given in the book. So 25.5. Now, this spacing, the spacing between the two toes, I'll call it as S. S is the spacing between toes of channel sections. How to calculate this? How to place this? Okay. Our main aim, it should be a square. Okay, the section should be a square. To make square, what I have, the condition is IXX should be equal to IYY. This is the condition. To calculate, yes, IXX should be equal to IYY to calculate yes value. Okay, now I'll calculate the IXX. IX of the whole section equal to twice the IXX of the channel section, because IXX of the whole section coincides with the IXX of the individual channel sections, isn't it? So IXX equal to 2 times IXX of the channel section is 6047.9 into 10 raised to 4 area plus A into H square. H square will be 0. If you write also, it is not countable, isn't it? I'll write 4211 into 0 square. This is nothing but 2 times the IXX of the section, 120.958 into 10 raised to 6 mm to the power 4. So this is the IXX value. This IXX value should be equal to IYY value to get the S spacing between the, isn't it, spacing between the channel section. Okay. Now, IYY equal to 2 times IYY of the individual section is 346 into 10 raised to 4, that is IYY, plus A, 4211. H square. So here B is 100 minus 25.5. Okay. That is CYY value. Minus plus S by 2. That gives me the distance. You got it? Okay. Now equating IXX equal to IYY. Okay. The S value we will get it as 83.73 millimeters. Okay, then I minimum is IXX equal to IYY here, 120.958, already we have calculated 10 raised to 6 mm to the power of 4. So R minimum, calculate the R minimum, minimum radius of gyration I by A. If you do that, 120.958 divided by 2 times 4211, that gives you 119.84 millimeters. That is the R minimum value. Then procedure as usual. Next is calculation of, now effective length here. It is given one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So LE equal to 0.8 of L, that is 0.8 of 4000. Sorry, it gives you 4000. The length is 6 meters. Yes, 6000. So it comes to 4000. Then slenderness ratio lambda equal to LE by R minimum. So LE equal to 4000 divided by, our R minimum is 119.84. this gives to 33.38. Again, the same procedure referring table 10. It is a buckling class of C. Once you get a buckling class C, the table we have to refer is 9C. Referring table 9C. Okay, if you refer the name KL by R minimum, that is lambda and FCD value. Okay, it is 33, means I have to take 30 value and 40 value. 30 value is 211. For 40, it is 198. I am interested in 33.38. If I interpolate it, the FCD value, I will get it as 206.61 Newton per mm square. That's the value for yield strength, 250. Okay. Now, compressive load. Our compressive strength equal to what's the value, AG into FCD. So 2 times 4211 is the area into 206.61 divided by 1000, so that directly I'll get in the kilonewton. If I do that, I'll get 1740 kilonewton, which is greater than 1600 kilonewton, hence safe. So I can write, adopt two channel sections ISLC 300 at 33.1 meter as toe to toe with spacing. How much you got to secure this spacing? 83.73 mm. This is the way you have to mention the section at the end for all the problems which the designs problems are given. You have to do in this way. So we have done problems of different varieties. In the very first problem, we have taken a single angle section and we calculated the safe load, whether it suits the load or not. Then we have taken two angles discontinuous strut, okay, where the angles are kept one side of the gusset plate and opposite side of the gusset plate. We have to note that when the channels are placed opposite side of the gusset plate, it will take more compressive strength. Already I have told when I have in the very first few problems where the members are given, we have find out the compressive strength. There itself I have shown you the two angles, if they have at the same side and the same angles, if I keep on opposite sides, either side of the gusset plate, this, the second case will take the more load. That should be noted. Then we have done the I section with the plates on it. So I section, plates on it, how to see, I have shown how to refer it, how to refer the steel tables and take the data. Now channel section, toe to toe, if they are placed, how to, when the spacing is not given, how to space it so that if spacing is given, provide the same spacing. If the spacing is not given, you should take the condition IXX should be equal to IYY and find the S value, the spacing between the two toes, and then design the calculations. Design calculations has to be done until you get a safe load, which should be greater than the given factored load. Okay, so this completes the design concepts of the compression member. Next class, we will discuss about lacings and